Welcome everyone. In this video, I wanted to talk to you about dot leaders and the significance of them when it comes to users of assistive technology. When we're talking about making our PDF files accessible, we're trying to create the best user experience for all users. Now, dot leaders fundamentally are there for the benefit of the sighted user, because when you have an element on the left side of the page that is kind of being directed to an element on the right side of the page, the dot leader is there for the benefit because it leads the eye to the right side of the page. Now, for users of assistive technology, those dot leaders are not particularly helpful, right? And as a matter of fact, in some ways, they can get in the way. And I want to demonstrate that to you right here. I currently have a file that I created for the purpose of this tutorial, and I'm going to read this document using JAWS.
Num lock off. Chapter 1. Dot dot dot. 1. Chapter 2. Dot dot dot. 5. Chapter 3. Dot dot dot. 21.
So you can see that JAWS, in this case, has gotten a little bit smart about this situation. JAWS knows that, hey, I don't need to read every dot that is there. However, it does read, as you can hear, three of them, right? And, you know, JAWS doesn't know that those dots are not valuable, right? JAWS is just trying to avoid the unnecessary repeating of those repeat characters, right? So that's something to kind of keep in mind here. Now, I'm going to quit JAWS.
JAWS home manual. JAWS context menu options men. Dot leaders dot peep.
And I'm going to also read this document using NVDA.
Welcome. Okay. Options grouping. Okay. Dot leaders dot PDF.
Chapter 2. 100 dot. 55 dot 5. Chapter 3. 100 dot. 53 dot 21. Chapter 4. 100 dot. 52.35.
So you can hear that obviously NVDA deals with this situation a little bit differently than JAWS does, but I think you would also agree that it's quite confusing because it's voicing a bunch of numbers before it voices the page number. And so for the user of assistive technology, this can be a really confusing and, to be quite honest, you know, a really bad user experience, okay? So I'm going to go ahead and quit NVDA here.
Okay.
And the example that I'm showing you is using Adobe InDesign, okay? Arguably, Adobe InDesign gives me the most control over this situation. But what I want to show you here is that the way that I created these dot leaders is the way that most people do this. And that is that if I open up my tabs pane, you'll notice that on the right side here, I have a tab stop. Let me open this up so you can see it a little bit better. So there I have a tab stop. And then in the leader field, I put a period, right? And so visually what that does for me is that it creates the visual dot leader going across. But what's also happening is that it's inserting that period repetitively until it fills the gap of the tab character. Okay. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to remove them. So I'm just going to come up here and delete that period. And you'll see now that the dot leader has kind of disappeared, because I want to show you a way that you can do this in Adobe InDesign that will yield a much better result than using the period in the leader field. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to come over here into our character styles panel, and I'm going to create a new character style in here. Now, actually, I'm going to deselect this. That way I get a blank one here, and I'm going to create a character style and I'm going to call it leader. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into my underline options category over here. Okay. And you could play around with these settings, right? But what I'm going to do here is I'm going to set the weight of my leader to 1 point. I'm going to set the color to black. And the type here, I'm going to set to dotted. Okay. And so what I'm doing is I'm creating the appearance of the leader completely using a character style. I'm not actually inserting a character to create this appearance. This is all being accomplished using a style, using visual formatting. There's no character being added here. So I'm going to go ahead and click OK, right? And now I have my leader character style created. Now I'm going to go to my paragraph styles panel. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to create a new paragraph style, and I'm going to call this dot leaders, okay? And I'm going to make sure that I apply that style to all of the text in here, okay? Now, within my dot leaders paragraph style, if I right-click on this and choose edit dot leaders, what I'm going to do is I'm going to come down here to the category called drop caps and nested styles. Now, you could do this, I should point out, you could do this using grep styles or nested styles. For this tutorial, I'm using nested styles because it's a little bit easier. But grep styles are super powerful. So if you want to take that approach, there's no problem in doing so. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to say new nested style, and I'm going to tell it to apply none up to one tab character. So I'm basically telling my paragraph style, which is called dot leaders, I'm telling it not to do anything to the text up to the first tab character, which is like right here, okay? Then I'm going to click new nested style, and I'm going to choose the leader character style that I created. And I'm going to tell it to apply the leader character style through one tab character, okay? And when I click off of this, this is basically going to apply the leader character through the tab character in this style, okay? And when I click OK, nothing is happening. And so I'm going to come over here to my leader character style. I think I forgot to do something here. And if I go into underline, yeah, it looks like I set all the parameters, but I forgot to turn it on. So make sure you do that, right? And when you do that, you'll notice that now the leader is applied to every instance within there. Now, you know, a lot of people may look at this and they might say like, oh, the dots are too close together. They're too far apart. There is a way of customizing that, right? So if you go into your stroke panel and you come into the hamburger menu here and choose stroke styles, you can create a custom stroke style, right? So I could say new, and I could say I want a dotted style, and I'm going to call this one leader dots, right? And then for now, I'm just going to click OK, right? I'm not really going to, you know, do anything to it. But to apply this, you have to go into your character style, into the leader style, and in underline options over here for type, you want to choose the leader dots that you just created. Now you'll see that when I did that, now the periods are spaced much further apart, right? So we've kind of modified that. But what makes this really powerful is if you go back to stroke, go back to stroke styles, now you can edit your leader dots. And if you adjust the pattern length, if you turn on your preview here and you adjust your pattern length, you're going to see that you can make an adjustment to the precise distance between those dots, right? So first of all, this is something you cannot do when you use the period in the leader field, right? Like some people will put a period and a space in there, or a period and two spaces, but it's not nearly as precise as the method that I'm showing you here, okay? So now that we've done this, right, what I'm going to do is I'm going to export this as a new PDF, and I'm going to call this one dot leaders new, okay? And now I'm going to return to my Windows environment. And on my desktop, I should have my dot leaders new document here. And now, right, if I read this document like I did before, I'll pause.
Chapter 1. 1. Chapter 2. 5. Chapter 3. 21. Chapter 4. 35.
Do you hear how much of a better experience that is to users of assistive technology? I'm going to go ahead and quit JAWS. And let's try the same thing with NVDA now.
Welcome to OK.leadersnew.pdf, page 1, chapter 2, 5. Chapter 3, 21. Chapter 4, 35. Chapter 5, 46. Chapter 6, 58. Exit, OK button.
So as you can see, and, you know, if I were to open up the tags pane here, right, and I look at my tags, you'll notice that within each one of these, that there is no dots that are being tagged within these. And I know, before anybody says anything, I know technically this should be tagged as a TOC, and I get that, but I created this manually, so that's why it's not tagged as a TOC. But most importantly, what I want to show you is that those dots are not tagged in the tags tree, right? That they're not characters that are being read by JAWS and NVDA, which I think you would all agree is giving the user a much better user experience than when the tab leaders are done by putting a period in the leader field of the tabs pane. So I hope you found that helpful, guys. And I hope it gave you a new approach to creating dot leaders when you need them. And it's going to help us all create much better documents for accessibility purposes.